Yep, here we go again. It's another edition of the Oregon Trail. The fifth edition, that is. And the reason I'm going to be doing this is because over these past two Oregon Trail videos I did, which were older versions of it, and I thought, why don't we just do that again with the same people, but this time in this game, so they can get or possibly die of whatever rather than just the usual cholera, typhoid, dysentery, and legs broken. Once again, L0rdMasta is the start of the show. And I gotta remember the names. It's Tony. Man, I always get in trouble with this name. Sorry, there you go. There we go. What else? Oh, yes. Derek, or what Nassara calls him, Daruk, as if he's like Farouk or something. Always get in trouble spelling with this, so if I get it right this time. There you go, Jonathan, first try. And, this fifth person is actually named after a cheese product. Damn it! There we go, Colby. But we're going to make the ages accurate to what I believe, based on what they sound like, since they hardly tell me of the ages. Look, I like to think they're both 13. Derek has to be slightly older. I know, not 65. No, 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 he ain't an old man. Not sure about Jonathan. I would assume he's 12. And I know my cousin Kobe's a grown-ass man, so my guess is 15. Because, again, they don't really tell me their ages, because I never asked them that question. I'm gonna be an adventurer. Oh, hang on. Started in March. Yeah, 1848. But going to Sacramento this time, and, ooh, what should it be? Prospector. That's right. I'm gonna get rich once this whole thing is blown over. Medical, river work, and cooking. These are all you need for such a long ass trek for L0rdMasta, Tony, Nassara, Derek, Jonathan, and Kobe. Yeah, let's travel the trail. Yada yada yada.
The merchants here in town offer basic packages of supplies based on the size of one's party and estimated length of journey. Of course, you can shop around on your own or add to the basic set. So, which package would you like?
This leaves me to... Oh my goodness. Well, I can't be spending too much, so... Oh yeah. John Quincy Adams, not the John Adams, although there's a lot of people in this world today that are probably named John or have Adams as the last name. Remember, just going to be buying only a few things since I'm on a limited budget here. Bring out the usual things. I don't want to buy the six hammer because I don't trust myself. Oh yeah, I can use the mouse wheel. So that way. Oh, da, da, da. You need the shells because, you know, if we get into a fallen rocks event, we're gonna have to dig it out. And if not, well, we can always get bring out the pickaxes, in which we made these pickaxes for the gold mining once we get to Sacramento. And we need winter clothes for not only because it's cold out, but when we get the spring and summer when the weather's warmer, we can always trade them. Because everybody wants coats since it's a high demand. 290. Hang on, okay. Wagon cover. drugstore. No, not the store where they sell drugs. Don't let that go to your head. Two of everything. What did it? Always two of everything because, you know, may have one for a spare for whatever purpose. Even if they are purposeless ones, such as, linseed oil, or alcohol, or whatever. Always bring brandy and whiskey with you. Oh, wait a minute. I think I'm the only one who has to... I'm 23 years old, I'm the only one in this wagon party who's allowed to drink. Whereas the rest of you aren't allowed to drink. what the hell was? Just get a few more bullets, one more. And a spare rifle in case one we lose during the tip overs. And now we spend the rest on the oxen. Give me a dozen of them. $97. I have a bad feeling this is going to be overloaded and ain't going to be enough. Oh no, that's fine. 46 wagons, train number one. Why on earth would you go with 5 wagons and 16 people? That means you would go with only 22 folks. I mean, can you imagine traveling alone? I mean, that's what the older versions of the urban trail makes you want to think so. Now, let me save this game because it's going to be a long, difficult one. And just in case if the recordings didn't get through, then I can always reload and redo some of the possible things I may have screwed up on. So I'm going to have more than one save file. Maybe. Maybe. Alright. We have $97 and oh my goodness, I didn't see the temperatures. The high is 12 and the low is 6. So we're already freezing our asses off here. So let's skedaddle. I have a bad feeling it's going to be a disaster off the start.
I don't see how we can cross right now. The ice isn't thick enough. Maybe we can break through the ice and then ford or float.
Are you kidding? At these kind of temperatures, if we were to break, it'll just freeze right back up. It's one wide-ass river, so hope for the best. Told you so about the temperature reason. The high is 19 and the low is minus 4. Below 4 degrees. Well, first order of the day as Captain is. Continue as usual.
The ice looks thick enough to just drive our wagons across.
To be honest, I was hoping for that one to break because that would have been funny. Man, we're going fast. It's that gold fever, man. Now these temperatures are a bit more tolerable. At least in my opinion.
Hardy! You know I've been trapping and trading in these here mountains for near 20 years.
I don't see any mountains. We're in the middle of the Great Plains.
Thunderation! Last year, a young grizzly invited itself to breakfast. In the tussle, it bit me right on the shoulder. I reckon I'm not gonna take that from man or beast, so I bit it right back. That thar bar ain't bothered a soul since. If in some of your party take the scurvy, feed him a bit of raw wild onions. That'll cure him. Works near well as fruit in preventing it, too.
Okay, weirdo. Oh crap, blizzard.
Can't make much progress in weather like this. It would be risky to continue until the snow lets up.
Hope to God we had a... There we go. We're out of the woods. Mount Pisgah, eh? How are we? We're all good. I told you the winter clothing is good for y'all. To be honest, I should have brought blankets, but... I guess we don't need them now, do we?
Conditions aren't likely to improve anytime soon. We should go ahead and cross the river.
So far, so good. The last time I did this when I was, actually, I was doing it a week ago when I was getting familiar with that old game again. When I started around this time. And,
we should continue on our journey.
Let's not stop here. We ought to keep moving.
Damn, I forgot what I was going to say. Can you help me
out? You want to trade? I have cornmeal and other types of food. My name is Naomi. I'm of the Muskutin clan of the Potawatomi. I've seen many of your people moving westward on this road. About 50 miles from here is a large town, bigger than this one. If we don't have what you need here, maybe you can find it there.
Are you nuts? I know you asked for... No. If I wanted your cornmeal and you're going to give me 5 water kegs, are you nuts? Hey, why don't we trade winter coats for winter coats? Yeah, right. Like, whoa. For a moment, I thought I saw 5 winter coats. I'm like, my God, what a bargain. I don't think we need flour at this time. Not this much. I mean, good God. Yeah, when I started around this time in March, it was a disaster from the beginning. It took us a whole month or two to be around this region, even if we have to endure all the snowbound events and things like that. It was a rough winter, really. Here's Canesville, one of the starting towns. A Treaty of Guadalupe Hidalgo. I don't know what that is, but I know Guadalupe and a Hidalgo. That's both in Texas, you know, the state where I live. Huh, look at the name of this surgeon. Dr. Dagobert Ikes or Lynx? I don't know how that's spelled.
Oh! I've been told you're looking for a doctor.
No, we aren't.
I'll do the best I can. Mind you, I don't have access to all the modern equipment and medicines like the physicians back east. If you see any plants with reddish leaves, don't eat them or drink the water nearby. Those red leaves are a good sign of alkali.
You know, that's pretty good advice. But what if it's when it's fall season, when it's September and October and November? What, you know, all the leaves turn red. Does that mean alkali is everywhere? I'm screwed. And also, why is this portrait the same picture as you are? It's pretty cheap, you know that. I don't think there's anything for me to buy here except look at wanted signs. Cattle rustling. How many bacon? 492. I like how there's a ferry there, and yet it's floating in the water, or... No, I see a stick there, so it's not on the water, so the ferry is useless. Who needs ferries when you've got wagons?
This is Winter Quarters, where the first group of Mormon pioneers waited for spring until continuing on their way. It was a long, cold, harsh winter, and there was much suffering and death, but they endured. When you feel downhearted, think of those that came before. Draw strength and inspiration from them.
Let me give you some inspiration. Look at us. We went through a whole winter. We're all fine because we're all wearing winter coats. I don't know about you folks.
Now that it's spring, it's a good time to resume our journey.
No, it ain't. It's March 14th.
It's high time we'd be moving on.
Is this like the 4th or 5th river crossing down the Gulf, right? And look at that. It ain't broken again.
What? Stop and rest in this here freezing weather? Heck, if you ask me, we better keep moving.
It's snowing. We better get moving, otherwise,
Howdy.
Howdy.
Do you want to trade?
I am Pawnee. My name is Tall Raincloud. I have dried meat and 2 horses. What more is there to tell? Now is a good time for trading. Beware of our enemies, the Sioux. They are not your friends as we are. But if you don't want to trade, perhaps you're not our friends either.
You say you got 2 horses, right? Is that true? Oh no, you got 3 horses. But guess what? But you don't have anything I want for it. How about these 2 horses, huh? Oh my god, what is the matter with you? Oh wait, I'm a prospector. I don't have the good trading skills, per se. So we don't make good deals. I'm not here for deals. I'm here to get gold. That's the only way to make me money. And we're all doing okay, apparently. So let's save here again. Yeah. Should something terrible happen to any one of them, particularly Nassaro, I'll text him through Kick, and I'm going to ask him a question depending on what he's got. If it's something that is, you know, beyond me, then I'm going to have to ask him. You know, it's just like having a phone call from the old Who Wants to Be a Millionaire game show. I once played an interactive CD-ROM game years back.
Guten Tag! My name is Ilse Weismann. My husband Gustav and I are from Prussia. Gustav was a shoemaker in Berlin, but times are not so good there. In Western America, there is free land we hear, so we come here to start a new life. We have been told always to stay on the main trail and to check our supplies often. That sounds like very good advice, don't you think?
What is it? Cheapskate. There we go. The gods must be with us. Well, maybe not at this moment.
Cholera? What are we gonna do? That stuff spreads like wildfire. We can't stay here. It's in the water.
Though, it's gonna be a little difficult when it comes to, you know, helping out these people, because they're all in their teens. All in their teens, basically. Although, I do recall Epsom salts is the choice. Come on, get to Mormon Island and... Fuck. There we go. Take 5, everybody. There was this news I read as it was trending on Facebook, on my personal Facebook. There was this news that came from Thailand, where a python emerged from the toilet and bit a man there, right in the penis. Yep! A snake came out of the toilet, bit him right in the dick. Why am I laughing at that? Because when I reacted to that news, I was scared. Because every time I go to the toilet, look before you go. That's the new advice for me. Look before you go. Because you may never know if a snake could come out of that toilet, an alligator, a shark, or a piranha. Even when you take a shit on it, they'll eat through you. Please, no. Don't get too descriptive. We're in Mormon Island. Oh my goodness, rattlesnakes. I mean, it's cold out, so they shouldn't be out there. Yeah, at least he's doing alright. Sand and snow, don't they mix together? I don't think they don't.
I'm going to St. Louis to have me a look at civilization.
Really?
The game just ain't so plentiful as it once was.
It's cold.
And there's getting to be so many people passing by, I might just as well be in a city. Keep your ears open when you're hunting. One of them big cats pretty near got me last week.
Really?
So busy thinking about my supper, I almost became supper instead. And trade the Indians for some moccasins. Them shoes of yourn are looking worn.
Well, there is some truth to it. I mean, I do have new shoes, behind me. but my old shoes that I've been wearing, it's starting to wore out. It's got holes in it, it's got scratches, it's even been vomited on back in the end of February on Leap Day. So, when June rolls around, I'll start wearing the new shoes. And also, you said one of the big cats got you last week. Well, near got you last week. So you were dealing with a bear, and you've been right back. So you couldn't bite back against a cougar? You got any shoes, son? Huh? Wait a minute. You have mules? 4 mules. And 4 oxen. Is that how you're pulling your wagon? A team of mules and a team of oxen? I don't think they'll cooperate. I remember the last Orchid Trail 5th edition video I did when I did a wagon train full of mules. Mules. And they did not cooperate with me that much, and I was... And a lot of them got injured. They were very injury prone. Not as much as this one. Hey, it's that guy again, and I'm sure his reaction is probably like shaking his head like, God damn it.
We ought to stop for a while. The animal may yet recover.
Let's slow down because one of the beeswax. I thought he died. Oh, the ox died. Thought he died.
I found some wild pie plant, and Mama cooked it up with some sugar. Tastes almost like Grandma's pie on National Day.
I didn't know pies can grow on trees.
I walk most of the day, but Pa lets me ride a bit in the afternoon to work on my lessons. Don't tell, but sometimes I fall asleep when I ride. Don't bother chasing them prairie dogs. They're faster than you'll ever be.
Think prairie dogs faster than you? I'll tell you what. When I go hunting, I'm going to kill a single prairie dog just for you, just to prove it. That a bullet can be faster than a prairie dog.
I am Running Elk of the Lakota. You ask how we are. I tell you the buffalo are gone from the great medicine road of the whites.
Eek.
We must travel 2 days or more to find food for our families. We see the white travelers waste what they hunt. Why do you kill, yet leave most of the meat and skin for the coyotes and buzzards? If you waste the animals you kill, the Great Spirit will visit bad luck and hunger on you. The Great Spirit does not like waste. We use every part of the buffalo and give thanks for the gift it is to us. Go now, and don't come back.
Would you at least trade? I could make you very happy. Well, how about fish at least? I ain't giving you one of the coats, not yet, because nobody's died. No, I can get fish myself. I can get them myself. Just not today, alright? Oh, it's Derek.
I think we ought to stop for a couple of days. When people are all tuckered out, they tend to get sick, like this.
Derek once told me he had Greek toes. So let's give him a olive oil. I mean, the olive comes from Greece, right? Hang on.
Howdy, I'm looking for my cat Molly. Have you seen her? We hear there ain't many cats out west yet, and some folks will pay good money for one, so they can catch the mice and rats. We're hoping Molly will have lots of kittens that we can sell.
The mice. Yeah, the mice. Last year, we killed about 50-plus mice in 1 year in that house of mine because we used to have a dog, which we usually kept in a cage, and that keeps cats out, and that caused an influx of mice coming into our house. It was nuts. And when we got rid of that dog, the presence of mice have been reduced to almost none because, you know, dogs don't catch mice as much as cats do, so yeah. Can I have your cat?
We had a milk cow, but she died a while back. Now all Molly's got to eat is our meat scraps. If you got a milk cow, take good care of her. I think I missed the fresh milk near as much as Molly does.
I could have bought a milk cow back there, but I didn't feel like it. Only because they cost too much, because I'm on a budget still. Even if I'm $100, including got a $9 free trade thing. You know, the old barter system. Yeah. I'm sure some of you are probably bored right now. Let's go hunting. Hopefully I can find that prairie dog just to prove that son of a beeswax wrong. Remember, the Great Spirit does not like waste. If you waste what you kill or waste what you hunt, he visits bad luck and hunger on you. Well, oh, I think I see it. No, not the dead bear. There's something behind that bush. Hang on. I know what's coming out. He'll be coming out soon. It's the prairie dog. Headshot. Yep. You think I can't chase prairie dogs? Well, how about chasing a bullet, huh?
We ought to stop and rest for at least a day or two. A gunshot wound, even a minor one, can turn serious without proper care.
I should have never reloaded that weapon after killing it.
You sure it was an accident? We don't want any murdering varmints hanging about.
Bleeding in pain. Tarek's got a bad cold. Damn it! I was hoping it wouldn't happen. I cleaned a dress to one. That's it, we're resting a week. For Derek's behest, and especially at my behest. Because I'm stupid. Water should be warm by now. There we go. Now it's green. Fever, pus, filled Jonathan, what did you get? Oh my god, smallpox!
I figure there ain't much you can do about smallpox. Let's keep going.
No, give me a better one.
Smallpox? That spreads like the devil. We'd better leave that wagon behind.
Anybody?
I've had smallpox, so I can't get it again. Let me try to help.
Tell me what to do.
If it's smallpox, then we have to get a hold of a doctor immediately.
Son of a beeswax. Not even people are telling me. Smallpox, 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 small. Greatly feared disease because it's both severe and extremely contagious. Oh my goodness. Well, he does have a fever. Some accompanied by vomiting. He doesn't have vomiting. They're 2 or 3 days. Oh my goodness. I've been resting for a week and apparently during at some point as I was resting as I was trying to take care of myself of my gunshot wound, he gets smallpox and now he's got that pus all over him. On the face, arms, and legs, and they dry up after a week. Scabs. Healthy adults, good chance of surviving. Small children, elderly die at alarming rates. Oh my god, Jonathan! Lots of rest and fluids. Once it has smallpox, then you will become immune to the disease for life. I think smallpox, if I'm correct or not, based on internet research, that is the only disease in this world that is eradicated forever. So in the 1800s, they exist at that time. Damn. Damn. Okay, just 2 more days and then we'll try to get moving because we're going to try to get a fort, alright? Yeah, this sucks, man. Only Tony and Nassarl didn't get anything yet. You think you boys are laughing at us right now? Well, you're going to get yours soon. And I promise you that. I'm going to be checking the health constantly. Hey, can you help us with anything? Please?
I am Inuna Ina, whom you call the Arapaho.
My name is Green Eyes. Our chief is talks to the coyote. He doesn't know your language, so he will speak through me. My father was a white man. Talks to the coyote says that you are crossing the land of the Inuna-Ina. You should offer gifts for this privilege. Act as though you want to trade, but ask for nothing in return. I suggest you offer gifts. Talks to the coyote is a powerful man. He can be a strong friend or a strong enemy. Friendship with the Arapaho can be a great advantage to you on the next leg of your journey.
How about a free winter coat, Mr. Coyote? Can I call you that? Anyways. Yeah, we kind of need... If you had smallpox before, for God's sakes, help us! I don't know what to do! Oh, I thought somebody died for Jonathan or me. Oh my goodness, he's all better. It's a miracle. It's a bleeping miracle. But now, it's me and Derek that is the suffering. It's always a little man who suffers.
Howdy, people. My fare is ready to go. You want I should take you across the river? Costs $5 for each wagon. Once you get across the river, you go by the fort and stock up on supplies. Maybe do some wagon repairs. Won't hurt to rest up a few days, neither.
We don't need your ferry. Who would want to spend $5 on a ferry? Not me. At least the wagon parts have never been broke or something. But I'm gonna need something like pounds of nails.
They tell me someone in this wagon train is looking for a doctor. Is that true?
Well, based on the situation, I'm the one who needs the medical treatments compared to my friend Derek, who's having a bad cold for about 2 weeks. Whereas for me, I've got shot.
Well, to be honest with you, I haven't been in regular practice for a number of years. But I'll be right pleased to do what I can. Next time you get to a town with a decent pharmacist, you might want to stock up on some basic medicines. Of course, you might have a pretty good supply already.
All right. I think I'm, give me a hat. I think I'm in a mood for possibly hunting again. What the hell? Where's me? Where's Derek? Okay, there you go.
I say we visit the fort. This may be our last opportunity.
We don't need any supplies.
Well, I bought a hat. So, screw you. Yeah, I'm gonna save right now because you may never know, this might kill me. I just need one big ass animal, alright? The last bear I got was a small one, so just give me two bears, alright? I don't know if I'm gonna get... Oh! If I'm done hunting, leave that gun unloaded! Oh my god, that's a big one! Leave it unloaded. Alright. And don't get mauled! Alright, Derek. Derek's doing alright. That's good. I always hunt at Register Clip because it's one of my favorite places to hunt. Has it been almost 2 months already? Where are we in this blasted trail? Halfway there already. Wow. Well, here's Naboo to your right, far right. We're in the middle of this fort near Register Cliff. We're a Register Cliff near fort, you know what I mean? And then there's Sacramento on the far... Oh, wait a minute. Did I say far right on Naboo? I mean, yeah, I did say far right. Sorry, I'm one of those folks that don't get the difference between right and left, right? These. Damn it! Confused myself.
The animals are getting scared by the lightning and thunder. Perhaps it would be best for us to stop until this storm blows over.
How could it be severe if it's that cold? Logic. Even though there's like a 5% chance of one of my oxen gets struck by lightning, I do recall seeing one event. Even it happened twice in one game where an ox got struck by lightning, died instantly, and it automatically gives you the meat. You know, crispy ox. Oh my god, the winter is back. But all to be fair, it's because we're in the mountains.
Well, after this here crossing, it's goodbye Platte River. Goodbye sand hills and buffalo skulls. According to my guidebook, now we've climbed the Sweetwater Valley. Across the Continental Divide at South Pass. Once across the Rockies, we'll make a steep descent into the Green River Valley. The land gets drier the further west we go. But as long as we stay close to the rivers, we ain't got too much to worry about, at least not regarding water.
I don't see how we can cross right now. The ice isn't thick enough. Maybe we can break through the ice and then ford or float.
Matter of fact, we're gonna do just that. Now the river is frozen. Hey, that guy.
I am Inunaina, whom you call the Arapaho. My name is White Hawk. I'm waiting here for my son, who is trading nearby. Long before we ever saw wagon people like you, a rare white hawk perched on a rock near my father's teepee. I took it as a sign for my new name, and ever since has it been changed. The men here are fair traders, not like many others my son and I have met. Perhaps when my son returns, we can trade with you too.
I always love trading with natives, because they got fresh fruit! 6 pounds, unfortunately. Have some coffee, will ya? Fresh from Colombia. That's where all the coffee comes from, I believe. And that's where all the... You know what I'm talking about. God damn it, Osorio! Well, I can't get out of ice. Oh, this is something I can handle. Put some alcohol in that sprain. Rubbing alcohol. Not whiskey. Not wine. This isn't the... Whatever. I mean, I'm half sleepy, alright? So, I tended to be out of control. Nobody here is interested to talk to. Here we go, my second favorite place to hunt. Split Rock. Oh, I forgot. Apparently, I'm doing okay, despite the fact I'm bleeding in pain. And I'll be like, I'm doing okay. I'm just, bleeding. You know, shit hurts, but I'm doing alright. Let's hunt. I don't know who I was imitating as, so don't bother asking. If it's that cold out, then these animals should... Damn it! I saw something down there. I think that was a prairie dog again. But oh, don't go out empty. Hand it. Well, gotta live up to my promise. Aim for the ass. Try that again. There we go. Ass shot. I didn't reload. Okay. Just to make sure.
Dad, burn it, another cussed river to cross. Well, I guess there's nothing to do but plunge on in. Oh, there's some that say you ought to check out the depth of the river or worry about its condition. But I always say, just do it. Follow my lead. Don't listen to them other jackasses.
What on earth were you doing with the grandfather clock? You gotta be nuts! for him. Oh God. Now, God damn it. Just when I was being too confident for my own good.
If the wound's infected, we should take it easy. Maybe rest for a few days. If we're not careful, it could turn to gangrene.
Oh no, not gangrene. No. That would cut me leg off.
An infection requires cleaning, treatment with alcohol, iodine or hydrogen peroxide, and fresh bandages.
Anything else?
If the wound's infected...
You say the wound's infected? Clean it up and treat it with sulfur. That's the best thing to do.
Yeah, apply it to sulfur, and we can rest a little. And hope to God that I don't die of an infection. Just when I thought I was getting better. Just when things were getting better. Since we're in a halfway point of this trail, I believe things are going to be crappy now. Nasario got better from his ankle problems. Whereas for me, I'm still bleeding and discoloration and reddening. Yeah, everything's going to hell for me. For me!
I think we should hire someone to help us across.
Hey, you want some of my winter coats? Free winter coats. What? Let's try that again. Here we go. That's a much better deal. We should be... I should run a winter coat business. Whenever I get all the gold when we prospect it.
Can you help us find a doctor?
Why do you need one? I need a doctor. I mean, for goodness sakes.
My pa is sick, and we may not be able to travel till he gets better. We've been pushing too hard, and our health has suffered. When Pa can travel again, we'll go at a slower pace. Maybe you ought to do the same.
Yeah, right. In your dreams, pal. I mean, there's a fort down there nearby. See? No need to worry about. If there is a doctor here.
Howdy.
Howdy.
Hi there.
Is there a doctor in a mouse? I mean, a house? How about you? Are you the doctor? No. Whoever's the commander of the fort, why is there no doctor here? Are you the doctor? My goodness. Medicine. Oh, there you go. Well, we did already use one, so... We didn't lose any of... too much. Now, chain's what we need, because if that shit breaks again, we're gonna be... No. Okay. We still got the spare parts. Remember, we're going to Sacramento, so we will be going to desert country soon. But first, it'll be mountain country. Mm-hmm. Alright, let's save. To the Salt Lake alternate route, and hopefully things don't go to hell for me. I believe they might. You know what we haven't tried yet? Fishing. Let's try some fishing. We're gonna do a little bit of fishing, so that way we can get familiar with this thing. Looks big to me, but yet the thing says 3 pounds. Take a powder. Give me something. Fish. You gotta be riveting. Get out. Remember, this is not a food crisis where I would be storing these things. That thing's gonna be in the water soon in about 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I did that on purpose. I was holding the mouse button. God damn it! I want just at least 5 pounds, okay? Get fat, will ya? I don't usually reject things. You're getting closer. Come on, eat up, you pieces of... 5 pound, 5 pound, damn it, you missed. Hey, aren't you a 5 pounder? 2 pound more to that. Come on. Hey, you stole it from. There we go. That's 5 pounds, and that's a different fish. See, I just wanted to use that as an example. Why are the fish so damn small in these parts?
Hello?
Hello?
This here place is called Echo Canyon. If you call out like this...
Yee-haw!
Ain't that something? Most prominent echo I've ever heard. Some folks' animals are giving out under their load. They gotta be lightening their wagons, but when I see good flour and bacon left behind, I can't help but think of the hungry mouths there may be on the trail ahead. Sure do. If you gotta lighten your load, just remember that you'll always need food. And warm clothes, too. These mountains and canyons can get right cold, even in summer. Especially at night.
Well, damn. Then I shouldn't have dumped those winter coats, huh? Well, do you have any? Because I would like to have them back. Well, you got a raincoat. Who the hell wears raincoats? Matter of fact, who wears them anymore? In the world today. That's a lot of eggs. You guys have a jar all around. Now that's a deal!
Hello!
See what you did? You shouldn't be yelling because you're gonna cause an avalanche of rocks.
If we all pitch in, we can clear a path through these rocks in just a few hours. Let's get our tools.
Yeah, we better get the tools, you know, the same tools we've been using for the last 10 years. Oh my god, how did this happen? Jonathan had the smallpox. I mean, there's gotta be some sort of thing going on. Unless this is a smallpox-ridden place.
I've had smallpox, so I can't get it again. Let me try to help.
Oh boy, no sorry. Oh my god, nausea and vomiting. Jonathan didn't have that, now you don't. Now, you have a little chance of survival. Because, my god. I don't know about you, Nassaro. I mean, of all the people around here, at least you're the most decent one around here. 4 days, okay? Because... this is gonna be a bad thing. Hey, wait a minute. Okay, I'm no longer infected, but I'm still bleeding! Now this part's gonna suck.
We met a man yesterday who said he'd already been to California.
Oh, yeah.
His report bore a good account of the country and the quality of the land to be had. That was a relief to hear. Thunderation, I've been working for other folks all my life. In the new land, I'm going to have my own land and herd. Yes, sir, I can hear them cattle calling my name.
And at the same time, they're going to be calling you, saying, "Help, help, this cattle rustler's taking me alive. Help."
I hear California's the best place for raising cattle. Acres of wild oats keep them fat and happy. Oregon's more country for farming and lumbering.
You know what else California's the best place for? Mining gold. Come on. There's gold up in them hills. Son of a beeswax. Prospector. Perhaps I shouldn't rush things too much. I gotta be on watch for Nasario's health and mine. Oh, God.
Good day to you folks. My name is Philip Maddox. I'm an artist with this surveying expedition. The U.S. government has commissioned us to map the land and to bring back some illustrations of the Indians, as well as the plant and animal life hereabouts.
You know what else you should illustrate? How did smallpox get to us?
Check your supplies often. Can't stress too much the importance of that. And don't waste a whole lot of time hunting, at least if it isn't an emergency. You won't get much. You'll delay your progress, and you risk antagonizing the local Indians.
I got shot when I was hunting. Well, don't waste a whole lot of time hunting. You ever heard of... I don't have time to take frustrations on you. I wanted to get the heck out of here! Let's go down the hill. I was about to go down the wagon. Oh, these people in Great Salt Lake City ain't gonna like it when there's a person with smallpox and they're gonna be telling, "Hey, don't get in there!" Well, guess what? I'm in here, punks. Potato famine. Yeah.
Say, you folks heading out on the trail, be sure to check your supplies often.
That's what I've been doing.
If you're near to running out of essentials, you can usually buy more at forts or trading posts. If you got no money, you might be able to trade with other travelers for what you need, but don't wait until it's too late.
Howdy!
Damn it. Oh, Jesus Christ, that's a real killer. Lomax, Pesky, and Biggles, your attorneys.
Hello!
I understand you folks are in need of a doctor.
It's you again.
Well, I'll take a look at the patient and see if there's anything I can do to help.
Yeah, Nasara's got the smallpox.
Eat well, drink lots of fluids, and get plenty of rest. Best advice anyone can give.
Oh, and also I'm still bleeding in pain, so help a brother out, will ya? I mean, I can't take this shit anymore. Alright, just give us another week, alright? And then I'll buy what we'll need, especially what we lost from the tip-overs, like canteens or water kegs, since we'll be going to desert country. How are we? Nasario's better, and I'm not! When did I get shot? I'm actually gonna take this time. Where was I? Okay, I think it took... not far. Okay, it was on the 9th of April that I accidentally suffered a gunshot wound. And it's been 2 months since I got shot. Hey, look, it's him again, and he's right out there. Wisconsin has the 38th state. Congratulations, Wisconsin! All these cheeseheads are gonna be happy to know that. Alright, what can we buy from the store? How many can... look, stack up on canteens and water kegs. I believe that's what we need, right? What's the exact count? 8 canteens and 4 water kegs. Oh, that's not enough in my opinion. I think 2 more water kegs would do. How about you, Mr. Garland Walker? Oh, you're not... is Garland a man's name and yet you're a lady? I guess you're his wife. Oh. Must be a mom and pop store. Got any kids? Well, I guess it's the way it's gonna be. Today's June. You know, when I arrived at Salt Lake City, it was back in August when I did last run. I'm gonna go to a place where we don't usually go, ever, in the history of the Oregon Trail. Hardly anybody goes there. We're going to Salt Lake Cutoff. We are gonna avoid a bit of a desert. to mention everybody's fine but me.
You know, when I think of all the things I've seen on this journey, nothing has impressed me more than the violent thunderstorms on the plains. From the bullwhip crack of the lightning dazzling my eyes, to the cannon-like boom of thunder, the heavens issued forth such a volume of water, we were all soaked through in the first few seconds, and the hail sometimes.
I've seen hail twice this year. We had one back in early April, I think, where we had quarter-sized hail, and another last week we had pea-sized hail.
I take time each day to add a few words to my journal. I recommend you do the same. It lifts the spirits to record our progress, and it may prove valuable to friends and family that follow. Even generations to come may find it of some interest.
Yeah, I can imagine the children of the next generation of my children, and they're going to be reading such good bedtime stories of L0rdMasta until they get to the part where L0rdMasta got shot! Cross the damn river! I'm surprised we haven't had any tip-overs. Tricky again? What are you looking at?
Lordy, I've just about had it with these rivers. Can't wait to get back to civilization.
Well, I haven't been tipped over yet.
We're heading back while we're still able. We've had enough. Go back. Ain't nothing up ahead but disease, disaster, and death. Mark my words, you'll wish you had.
Well, we got the first two, but we haven't had any deaths, so how about this? You mark my words and say that I don't know what to say. Look, we only had tip-overs on the hills, but not at the rivers. Rattlesnake Pass. Does it really live up to its name? Salt Lake Cutoff, Salt Lake Cutoff, Salt Lake Cutoff, Salt Lake Cutoff. There it is. Large number of rattlesnakes in the vicinity. Not again! Someone's gonna be bitten by a rattlesnake. I predict that. Ah! Derek! You got bit in the dick! Yep. Just like that guy from Thailand.
We should stop and rest. Rest is important for recovery from a snake bite.
Why are you laughing? What's up with these rivers?
We've been dilly-dallying enough over the past few days. I'm anxious to put this river behind me and make a few more miles today. I've heard enough debate about how to cross. I reckon it's time to get on with it. There's enough wagons to get over yet today. Keep your head about you and you won't run into no trouble. It's them that plunge ahead without thinking that gets in a pickle whilst crossing rivers.
Well, this is going to be a bit to deal with because it's difficult, it's rainy, so let's pray the gods are with us. Once again, L0rdMasta has proven to be the River Master. See, we didn't need to go then cross no cross that river. I'm stammering, alright? I'm starting to lose my sense of the English language. I'm still bleeding. I think I'm going to bleed for the rest of my life. I'm actually pumping more blood than I'm losing blood. I think I see what's going on. I see the pattern. Oh, that's a mistake. Why did I do that? If you're going to go continue as usual rough trail, you have a tendency to tip over or what else. And now Tony's got a sprained ankle. Tony, that's the very first thing you got. You better as well call 911 on that one. Waiting for shit to happen. Well, Derek. Swollen and painful joint. Yeah, that's what ankles do, yeah. Well, if the olive oil worked for Derek, I'm sure it'll work for you.
That there's my wagon over on the other side with nothing much in it but a barrel of flour and some bedding. Soon as I get these animals across the river, I'm going after that thieving rascal who robbed me.
Robbed you?
I paid that varmint $2 to help us cross. That smiling coyote took the wagon cross, and whilst we was preparing the animals, he took the valuables out of the wagon and lit off like a jackrabbit being chased by a bobcat.
Well, why didn't you shoot him, then? Otherwise you wouldn't do all the chasing. If it was $2? Well, if you gave him more money, then that wouldn't happen. You'll be like, $2? That guy's jacking me. I'm gonna take your wagon.
I'm so darn spittin' mad I can't tell you nothing, excepting to please get out of my way. And if you see that sow-bellied scoundrel, hold him for me.
Yeah, I'm so darn spittin' mad, I wanna get this over with. Oh my god. I was hoping that would never, ever happen.
If you don't have a spare wheel, maybe you can trade with somebody for one.
How about I fix it? And guess what? I can't. Despite all the hammers, all the saws, all the shovels, all these tools we need, including the nails, we couldn't fix that damn wagon! Not again! What? Okay, good. Sulfur. My god, is nature against me? Is it because of the sins I committed? And then the good Lord will be like, no! You get infected! But then again, we're almost to California, as the trail suggests. But the morale is still high, surprisingly. We were never pissed off or anything. We're all still happy and joyful, despite all the things that are happening, with everybody shooting themselves or getting bitten or twisting our ankles for this. It's a miracle. It's a miracle. I'm pissed now. I'm gonna take a risk at hunting. Like that guy said earlier, so darn spittin' mad, I'm gonna shoot this bird. Also, that's a miss. Stay down! Piss off. You too. Yeah, I'm gonna go on a shooting rampage. Oh, look at that. A family of prairie dogs. You think it'll be faster than this bullet? No? He didn't catch that, huh? Okay, how about you? Yep, he took a whiff of it. How about you, huh? You wanna outrun it? No. Hey, we got another customer. Headshot! Yeah, I'm extremely mad now. Anybody else? Oh, shit. Good. L0rdMasta is anti-animal and anti-air. Anti-animal? That's a little too harsh because, you know, animal rights groups, which were non-existent in the 1800s. Hold on. I might miss the bird. Remember, one of my contractors said to me, he'll pay me greatly. $500 if I were to shoot this prairie dog in the head. Yep. Mission accomplished. Let's get them out of here. L0rdMasta, you've gone nuts. You egg sucking dog. What is the matter of you? God, I am gonna die. The sins of our fathers. I'm gonna fucking die. Take five. Oh my god. I was so mad at this world and I... Oh my god, I finally got better from the infection and the bleeding and the everything. Just when I was having a near-death experience. Yeah. Now I'm feeling poor. Yeah, I'm still having these, you know, effects from that damn... I'm getting goosebumps right now. Hope that turns out okay. Hope everything turns out okay for me.
Ah! Más emigrantes, ¿eh? Por donde vas te topas con ellos.
Oh my goodness.
No hablo inglés, pero sí hablo idiomas indígenas, los cuales me ayudan a comerciar con ellos. No muchos americanos hablan estos idiomas.
Well, does advice mean anything to you?
Le aconsejo que junte algo de forraje en esta pradera. Oh, sus animales lo necesitarán en el desierto que viene más adelante. ¡Adiós y buena suerte!
Well, do you understand the language of trade? I need a friggin' drink. Yeah. I need a drink. Bad, bad, bad. Damn. Okay, just one set, okay. Just one set. Like, that means anything. 10 bills of hay. Alrighty.
Howdy, friend. I just now finished recording the day's events in my journal. It'll be a valuable memento of this endeavor of ours.
Except the part where I was killing prairie dogs like mad.
We've made it to Humboldt Sink. Dreadful place, ain't it? Strangely beautiful, though. I see the road splits here. Which way are we going? Well, it'd be my druthers to stay on the main route. The one that branches off to the right, I think. I reckon the other one's okay, too.
Maybe we better consult our guidebook before deciding which road to take.
Which way is west?
I'll tell you where west is. West? It's over there. You know, point it to your left. You know, west. You know where Utah, Wyoming, Nebraska, Illinois is. Now, why don't you... go take a powder and beat it! The Carson route. The Carson is the best route. I'm surprised everyone's gonna survive this except for me because I've had too much shit to deal with. We're gonna travel by day. The weather isn't that hot. It's gonna cooperate. Hope nobody drinks that alkali water. God damn it. We spoke too soon. And we don't have anything to make it feel better. Doesn't the alkali sickness have anything? Here we go. You idiot. You drank the water, didn't you? And remember what the doctor told you about the red leaves.
Derek, you stupid.
Let's see, let me read the rest of this. Death is inevitable within 24 hours. Oh my god. Greased lard, vinegar, mixture of flour and water. I should have never dumped the flour. What am I... 50-50 chance? Oh my god. Derek, you are now officially... the dumbest man in the universe. We're gonna rest for 2 days. You might die, okay? Because you have done... It was a 50-50 chance, and somehow you survived. Apparently somebody else in the wagon train, I assume someone else probably helped you. You called for backup. You called 911, didn't you? You are a lucky bastard, you know that.
Well, now I've surely seen the elephant.
Did you know?
I mean, the desert was just about all that a human being can stand. I'm at the limits of my endurance. Well, we certainly can't turn around and go back now. That'd be the death of me. After we rest up here a bit, I reckon we just gotta keep pushing on.
You didn't drink, did you? Keep it up. Unlike Derek here, He drank it. He done a bad thing.
I think we ought to keep going.
Let's keep going. Let's keep going.
I think it's time we be moving on now.
Yeah. We're gonna keep on moving. Get the out. We ain't stopping for nothing. I am trying to get through this trail. If you do it on the third time, I'm going to start shooting at the sky. Until blood comes on and probably kill one of those folks that are conducting the storm. Oh, here we go again with this BS. God damn it. Of course that would happen. Hey, winter coats. Take all the winter coats. We're already near the end anyway. Please! Get the axles! Get the wheels! Or get a knife. A hunting knife. Was this your wagon?
I'm a duly deputized officer of the law. We have reason to believe there might be a thief and cheat among you.
Oh no, it ain't me. Hey, hide the knife, Derek!
A blacksmith a ways back said he did some work for a fellow in a wagon train, but he took off without paying him.
Really?
I don't see anyone here that matches the description of the varmint we're after. You folks keep your noses clean. You hear?
Yes, sir. Oh, shit. I thought the thief came and stole the wagon parts. I thought he's the thief. He was impersonating as an officer. Imagine that. No fruit or vegetables. Well, looks like we're going to go have to buy some or gather. Oh, and also, the town's name is Dry Diggins. How about that? Dry Diggins, everybody.
Let's go into town.
Well, I just finished checking my supplies, and I can't say we're really in need of much of anything. I think I'll mosey over to the store they got here and see if there's anything I can use. You might want to check your animals and be sure they're okay. If need be, you might be able to get a few fresh ones here before we move on.
Well, we're all doing okay. I mean, we're all finally going to get over. It's a hell of a trip, huh? Let's go into town. What on earth? Look at this. There's the midget version of him, and there's a man right here.
Say, you're one of them folks from that wagon train there, ain't you? Where are all you people coming from? I'm trying to get word of my cousin who's supposed to be out on the trail.
Well, I got too many cousins.
He came out of Kentucky and was traveling with two young'uns. His name's Brown, Elisha Brown. I'd like to tell him about a sadness in his family that happened just a week after he left.
Really?
Send what mail you can to your family as you travel. Forts are a good place for it. Ain't much else we can do except keep asking if someone's seen our people along the way.
Hey, you guy on the far right. Why are you sleeping standing up? It's kind of dangerous, you know. A T-Rex sleeps standing up, you know.
Hello.
Hi.
Howdy.
What's the sign? I'm sure some of you are wondering, why are you laughing, L0rdMasta? Why are you laughing, L0rdMasta? L0rdMasta, why are you laughing, my boy? It's because, Lemuel Knapp, horse theft. You know what? I would rewrite it and say kidnapper. You know, Knapp, his last name.
Hi there.
Hello. Howdy.
Hey, wait a minute.
Hello. Hello.
Same voice.
Hi there. How you doing?
Howdy.
Ooh! I've been told you're looking for a doctor.
No. We don't need no doctors. No doctors.
Say, you're not from around here, are you?
Nope.
Oh, I bet you're with that wagon train that's passing through. You folks are more than welcome to stock up on supplies here. Watch yourself in these parts. Not everyone's as friendly as I am.
Not everyone's friendly as you.
Hey! Watch where you're going. What do you think? You own the place?
F you.
You're one of them immigrants going out west on the trail, ain't you? You just watch your step around here. I ain't the only one who don't take kindly to careless strangers.
Hey, we're all careless strangers around here. So I just suggest you go to Zampf and Winkelmeyer. That's a hell of a place. Oh, I needed to buy something here. This was what I came for. You got any mining supplies? Because we're ready to get some gold. Yeah. Gold is what we need, and gold is going to be our greatest thing. Since we have no fruits or vegetables. Well, I'm going to go get some right now. Here. Gonna get them all. Stop your bitching. Poisonous. Damn it! Hey. Damn it. Hey, come on, Axon.
How's doing, friends? You must belong-
Whoa! You back them animals up right now. We don't let no animals into the compound. Especially if they ain't been checked for disease.
We have been getting a lot of disease. Especially smallpox. Tony, you're next in line to get the smallpox.
I'll tell you, Mar. A lot of you people coming in from the States, practically at Mr. Sutter's behest, and you go and abuse his hospitality.
It ain't right.
Well, you seem polite enough. I reckon I got myself worked up for nothing, and I do apologize. Out in this rugged country, a man gets to forgetting civilized behavior. If you're looking for supplies, the trading post will fix you up with what you need.
Man forgets his civilized behavior? I think he's calling me out. You want to see civilized behavior? Well, he ain't afraid of a little competition, huh? Look, we're gonna hunt just outside of your backyard. You wanna see civilized people? Huh? Damn it! I'm asking to get shot again. Matter of fact, reload this gun. Ha! Oh! Fuck the world! That's it. Look, he's got food poisoning, and I got shot. I asked for it. Now, let's go get some gold. Yep, I got shot again, like I've been in a war. What are y'all people looking at? So, how much gold did we get, huh? Stone to crows. Look at that. What's my final score? Good God almighty. One person in fair health, and that's him down there. Not me. I'm not the one in fair health. I'm bleeding in pain, and I'm in good spirits because we got gold! L0rdMasta Prospector for gold along the Feta River, California in 1848 and made a strike worth of 2,360. Bittersweet and proud memories spent on the Oregon California Trail. Bittersweet and proud keywords. 1869 gold struck on a tract of land owned by L0rdMasta provided even greater wealth, of much of which was donated to charity. An early 20th century descendant repeated this good fortune by striking oil in Southern California, providing the family of continued affluence and influence. Yep, L0rdMasta is a millionaire, apparently, along with his descendants, and even up to today. The L0rdMasta of today. Yeah. You know, the same L0rdMasta that you see me do videos on. Yep, I got shot again. That's something I'm used to in life. Well, not really. But, regardless. We've made it through, all right. I guess. Nobody died. There was a lot of near-death experiences, and we made it to the top. Made it to the top. Even despite all the trials and tribulations we went through, and not to forget temptations, of, you know, trying to ask to get shot or something. To be honest, I was hoping for a mountain lion to maul me at the end. That's what I was hoping for. Because that would have been the greatest. Well, that was the Oregon Trail. The first video of that kind in more than a year, I think. That's the last time I did a video on that. And the next time, if I were to do a PC gaming video, I'll be back in action in a month of June sometime. With most likely Project Reality. I will return to that. And whatever video uploads that'll come from the Xbox One from the different works that I do. I hope you enjoyed this outlandish experience of the Oregon Trail. Although I've done some more outlandish things, but this one is right up there. So, good night everybody, and good morning Europe, or whatever time zones of y'all people live, since I'm a bit world-renowned. So, see you later.